慈济的大爱精神感动了许多实业家，包括在美国有1500家分店的熊猫餐饮集团总裁陈正昌鼓励主管参加近思生活营，更在主管会议上面邀请志工来介绍慈济。而在达拉斯志工举办的英文志工培训课程，就有十位熊猫餐饮集团的分店经理来参加，一起投入志工行列。
As in the staff from now, we don't call you Mr. or Mrs. We call you brother and sister.
守十戒、问讯、行进、用餐礼仪，再再都是从个人做起来成就团体之美。慈济达拉斯分会举办英文志工培训，有十位熊猫餐饮集团分店经理以及三位大爱幼儿园的家长参加。忙碌几乎是每个人差点缺席的正当理由，但现在无不庆幸自己的坚持。
I never whole day to eat vegetarian. That's my first time the whole day.It's really clean. Now my body is really clean. My body is really clean. It's true.
We continue to have, unfortunately, because of the global climate change, we continue to have problems with the environment. And I think the natural disasters continue to get worse all over the planet. So if that's the case, we need to prepare. And I think what you're doing now in having the English program is very, very helpful.
I came from a poor country also.You know, and I forgot what it meant to be poor. So this reminds me that I need to do something to help others.
的确，有慈济人的地方总会被引导出该做些什么好事的想法。曾经犹豫要不要参加实业家近思生活营的丹尼尔，一趟花莲行，思想行动都改变了。
And it changed my thinking in a big way when I came home. I started growing a garden. We changed our driveway to the same pavers that you have, so the water goes into the ground. I've been diligent about the bamboo bank, but you know, more than just giving money, it's about making an impact as an individual.
从自己做起，扩展爱的同心圆。熊猫集团总裁在总公司举办全美高阶主管会议，邀请慈济人与会，介绍慈济。
也可以介绍一下呢。就是说在 Panda 跟慈济的合作 的关系，不但是在洛杉矶，在美国其他很多地方呢，我们都有很多活动互动，把这个爱传出去。
开拓事业版图是求安身，生活有着落；深耕行善置业是求立命，精神上有所寄托。美国慈济志工走访各企业，广邀天下善事，回馈越加的丰厚。大爱新闻真善美志工美国报道。